Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. As you can probably tell from today's video, we're gonna be talking all about loungewear. So I just realized I always point to the top whenever I talk about the titles, but I guess all the titles usually are at the bottom of the video now. So as you can see from down below the title, we're gonna be chatting all about loungewear today. Toronto, at least where I live, is currently on lockdown. We've more or less been in lockdown since November, so it's been almost 3 months-ish now. This is our second lockdown of the pandemic. The first one definitely was a lot more stringent. There's still many non-essential stores open here and restaurants are still open, whereas the first one around, everything was shut down. The only thing you could really do was groceries and getting any prescription medications or picking up meds that you need from pharmacies. So even though it is still a little bit more relaxed than the first time around, there's not much we really can do. So I feel like since the summertime, we got the chance to go outside, enjoy the nice summer weather. We were starting to wear some of our nice clothes again, but now that we're deep in the midst of winter and still in lockdown, I've just essentially reverted back to wearing loungewear 24/7. And if I ever put on a pair of jeans, I consider that a good day. Every once in a while, when we go out and run errands and do groceries or walk Kobe, I kind of dress up a little bit because I figured, you know what, might as well just put on some nice clothes for once and not just parade around in my pajamas and loungewear all the time, because that's literally what I do. But yeah, majority of the time I'm just in loungewear. So actually living within this past year of literally in loungewear 24/7, I think I've kind of rounded up some of my best and favorite loungewear pieces that I've had and worn. I've definitely acquired so many new ones this past year, but I want to share with you guys some of my favorite ones. So let's just jump right into the video. So the way that I built out this collection was based on which pieces I actually found myself gravitating towards the most and constantly wearing. I know it's going to sound a little bit gross, but some of these items I've actually probably worn them for at least a week straight without changing into a different outfit before washing them, primarily because we're not really going anywhere. So I put something on to go to sleep in. It's so comfortable for me to sleep in that I wear it all day long, and then it's still so comfortable that I sleep in it again. So yeah, they've definitely gone through their fair share of times being worn, and I think after wearing them so much, I can honestly say these are my favorite pieces. So we are going to start off with knit sets because you guys know I have a deep obsession for them. Starting last year around January, actually before the pandemic really settled in, I fell in love with knit sets. I thought that they were really cute ways to be comfortable yet chic at home still. And you guys know I love my matching sets. So when you can take apart your knit sets and have versatility to wear them like either together or separately, then yes, I am a fan of that. Also, I just found that knit sets are really cute because you can not only wear them at home lounging around, but you can also wear them outside as well. They're just as cute at home and out. So I just really like that versatility. They're not a pair of pajamas that you can only wear when you're at home. So yeah, which is why I fell in love with them. So I've kind of gone through all the knit sets that I currently own and pulled out my top three favorite ones, and I will run through each of them with you and let you know why I love them so much. First up is a set that I discovered from Victoria's Secret and their collaboration with For Love and Lemons. It's actually a three-piece set. You know what? Actually, all of these are three-piece sets. So first off is this pair of kind of like fuzzy white shorts. They're really soft. Actually, this one you wouldn't really wear outside because it looks more like underwear than it does a pair of shorts, but it is so silky soft. I don't know what material they use. Let me just check this really quickly so I can let you guys know. I apologize preemptively for the lighting. It is all over the place right now. I usually shoot in the middle of the day when there's a lot of natural sunlight. So if you guys see it coming and going, bright to dark, yellow to blue, I apologize, it's because of the sun. But back to the knit set. So I just double checked and these are 100% nylon. This is the matching top that goes along with it. It's a slightly longer crop top, though it is a crop top. It's not one of those ones where it cuts off right underneath your bust and looks like a bra. So you can definitely wear this out as a shirt underneath other blazers or other tops as well. I actually really like this one because it's a V-neck on the front and on the back. So it kind of really shows off your back if you were to wear this in the summertime as a top on its own. Once again, same material, really, really comfortable, super soft, and also like ultra stretchy so it doesn't cut into you anywhere at all. They also have a matching cardigan for this, and it comes in white. This one's a little bit more extra, and I definitely think you could wear this outside of just wearing at home in loungewear as well, because the sleeves actually are kind of balloony. There is some puckering at the top here where the sleeves are, and when you get down to the wrist, it has like a really tight cuff and also balloon here. So it's a little bit more trendy and kind of outdoor, everyday casual wear cardigan-esque, but you can definitely get away with wearing it at home. You just have like a really cute chic outfit. I wore this when we went to Florida last year. obsessed with it. So soft. It was really hot when we went, but you know what? I still wore it because it was super soft and cute, and I just like the texture, the material of my skin. You guys know I am a nut for soft fabric, so I instantly gravitated towards this one. I think when this one first came out, it actually came in like the salmon pink color as well. I'm not really that bright, vibrant person, so I didn't gravitate towards the salmon pink one, but when I saw the white one, I was instantly drawn to it and just knew I had to have it. The cardigan also has some other cute details as well. On the front here, the buttons are actually these kind of like reflective mirrory rhinestones. It's a little bit gaudy, but I kind of like it. It gives you that kind of very early 2000s pop vibe, and I am here for this. Pair this together with the white crop top and a pair of jeans, and you're ready to go for the summertime. Or you can just wear it at home with these itty bitty white bottoms here. I don't know where else I would ever wear this to. I'm definitely not gonna be wearing this out. This one is more of a home piece for sure. But I love this one. This one is from the Victoria's Secret and For Love and Lemons line. I don't think it is currently available. I will try my best to find it if possible. But I think this one actually really mimics like the Skims line. So I'll also link the items from Skims as well that are kind of similar to this. Kim Kardashian released like an all white cozy line that was really soft and fuzzy. And I think it has like similar aesthetics and finishes to this. So if you guys are interested, you can probably check it out there, because I believe all of her pieces are constantly restocked, whereas the Victoria's Secret and the For Love and Lemon one is actually more of like a limited edition collection run. Whenever they just have collection launches, that's when they have the products on hand. Next up is another knit set that I probably have worn the most, to be honest, and it is this kind of, I don't know how to explain it, like a chocolate brown taupey color. So this is the crop top. It's a little bit longer. It definitely falls more like a tank top. It comes with a matching pair of knit shorts. I've absolutely worn these out in public during the day because they're a little bit longer. It doesn't have like that underwear cut. And then along with that, a cardigan as always. The cardigan looks like this. This is also a cropped cardigan. It doesn't go all the way down. If you do wear high-waisted pants though, you can definitely get away with wearing this cardigan with your pants without showing any skin in the middle. I wore this one so much all throughout spring and summer, primarily the top and the cardigan with jeans, high-waisted pants, that sort of shebang. And then I wore the entire set in the summertime. I've definitely also worn these two pieces on their own in the summer too. One thing I did want to note is that this one is from Zara, so it is no longer available to purchase. I will try my best to find some similar sets and link them down in the description bar below for you if you are interested. But yeah, unfortunately this one's no longer available. I purchased this one back in January of last year. I brought this one with me when Peter and I went to LA, wore it so much. I found this one really, really comfortable. The material was a little bit scratchy though, because I think there is some wool quantity in this. I lie, it's 76% polyester and 24% acrylic. So I think it's probably the acrylic that makes it really itchy. But I like this one because it's nice and form-fitting. It looks really chic as a top on its own, even when not worn with the cardigan. And I was a huge fan of this one. This one actually provides a little bit more coverage than the other one did, because the top is a little bit longer. And because the waists of the pants are so high up, I actually found that sometimes it overlapped with the top and I could actually tuck the top in if I wanted it to have like a complete play suit look. Otherwise, some other days when I want to be a crop top, I actually folded the bottom down. If I was wearing a strapless bra, then I would tuck it in underneath the bra just to get that really cropped look. But loving this one, and it's nice to have like a different change of color. I've definitely mixed and matched some of my knit sets as well and worn one cardigan with a different top just to get a different look. If you want to wear the cardigan and the shorts with a different top underneath and vice versa, I think it's just really versatile and get so many different looks with these matching knit sets. You guys know my love for neutral, so of course after I had a white and a brown, I still needed to get a beige. This is another one from Zara, so once again, no longer available because once they sell out, they don't bring them back. This knit set is a little bit different, and I always try to differentiate all of my knit sets from each other so that they're not overlapping. That way they all fill different holes in my closet. So this one actually comes with this bra style knit top here. I actually really like this one because I can wear this with so many other outfits. I've definitely worn this underneath blazers as a top on its own, and I kind of like that it's a bra top because the other two are longer crop tops. So this is a little bit more of a diverse, different style of a knit set. This set feels a lot more lingerie-esque because there is that bra cut style top, but I still like it nonetheless, and I've 100% worn out. I think crop tops were super, super popular last summer and the summer before, so I think it's fairly acceptable to still wear this out as a top on its own. Plus, I live in Toronto and everyone here is extremely liberal with their clothing choices. You could probably definitely walk around downtown with just nipple pasties on and no one would blink an eye, just because everyone is so crazy when it comes to their fashion expression. So yes, I have definitely worn this out as just a bra top to go and run errands, do groceries, get ice cream, and it's been perfectly acceptable here. The matching pair of bottoms are a pair of shorts. It's very, very similar to the brown knit set that I just showed you guys. Very high-waisted, a super thick waist as well, which I really like, so it helps keep everything in. But it's also really comfortable, and the knit is fairly loose, so it doesn't feel restrictive on your skin. I actually wore this set also a lot when we were in LA. This one and the brown one were my two favorites. And then to complete the set, it comes with a beige cardigan. So this one, dissimilar to the other two, is slightly more oversized. This is definitely a cardigan that you could see being sold on its own as an individual piece. Even outside of the set, I can definitely see a lot of retailers selling a cardigan like this just to wear over any other tops that you have. It's nice and big. It's fairly oversized. It has three buttons at the front. I was drawn to this one because of the tortoiseshell buttons. You guys know I love tortoiseshell anything. And it also has two pockets on either side of the front here. The sleeves are really nice and long and drapey, and they have really thick, chunky cuffs as well. I've also definitely worn this cardigan on its own as an outfit with like jeans and a different top or even a t-shirt and just layered it over top outside of wearing it with the set. And that's primarily what I love about the versatility of these knit sets. They look really great at home, but you can take them apart and wear them separately with other pieces outside casually too. So that kind of sums up all of my knit sets. We're gonna be moving on to matching sweat sets and sweatshirts. I have an obsession as well with crew necks. I actually started collecting them about 2 years ago before they just kind of surged into popularity online and on Instagram. I got one from San Francisco, like one of those tacky tourist ones, just because I thought it was cute. And at that time, it wasn't really a big popular style to have, and I just wanted a really kind of memorable sweater to wear around the house to relax in. I kind of decided that I wanted to acquire a sweater anytime I went to a different destination, just as, I guess, a souvenir and as a practical piece. I'm tired of having things being brought home from places that I travel to that aren't really memorable pieces that end up just collecting dust at home. So I've kind of made a commitment to myself to only pick up souvenirs that are practical now to me. So that kickstarted my obsession with crew necks, and ever since then I've actually acquired a couple more. I have a fluorescent yellow one from Topshop that I probably don't even wear anymore, to be honest. So I definitely will be listing that one on my Poshmark soon. If you guys want to follow me on Poshmark to see anytime I upload any pieces from my closet, you can follow me via my handle right here. Make sure to follow my closet, that way you get notified anytime I upload new things. Otherwise, I do frequently put up notices on my Instagram stories whenever I upload new items. I have one from Topshop that's a fluorescent yellow one that I don't really wear anymore, so I'm thinking of listing it onto my Poshmark. If you guys want to check out my closet, you can search my handle below. This is my username. Make sure to follow me on there if you guys want to get notified anytime I upload brand new pieces to my closet. Otherwise, if you're following me on Instagram, I do frequently do updates anytime I upload new items that are my story, so you can check that out as well to stay up to date on new pieces that are added so that you guys can shop my closet. But back to the topic at hand, crew necks. I love crew necks. Not only can you wear them by themselves with matching sweat sets, which I will touch base on later, but I actually really like to wear my crew necks at home with leggings, like my workout leggings, just to go around the house if I'm running errands. That's more of like my lazy, casual, comfy vibe. It's not a really dress-up style of loungewear, but I like it. On days when I want to be a little bit more relaxed, I definitely gravitate towards my crew necks. I also find them extremely comfortable because they're so loose and baggy. You have so much mobility when it comes to your body. So yeah, that's why I've been obsessed with them recently. Pro tip to you guys, shop in the men's department. I know that a lot of brands have crew necks for women, but I feel like they're just not cut right, if that makes sense. And I prefer the more stolen from the boyfriend vibe, or like that vintage look that you just thrifted a sweater. So if you really want that look and you can't find it anywhere, I would highly recommend searching in the men's sections of all of your favorite retailers. You're definitely gonna find some. My favorite find thus far has been this baby blue H&M one that I picked up earlier in the summer. If you guys watched my pastels H&M haul earlier this summer, then you'll definitely have seen this sweater along with a bunch of different other colors. I picked up this blue one. There was a pink, yellow, and a light green, and I think that's it. There might have been a beige too. I can't remember 100%, but these ones were all like $12.99 on the men's site. I like to frequently check my analytics to see which links you guys click on the most, and I swear to God, 50% of the time, it's just this damn sweater. So apparently you guys really, really love it. I'm gonna see if I can link it down below as well if they still have it available in stock. If not, I'll try to find some similar ones from other retailers as well. But I have worn this sweater to death. It is already starting to pill a little bit, so I'm probably gonna have to shave it off. But it doesn't pill that bad compared to a bunch of other sweaters that I had. And for the price, it's held up pretty well. I get questions on here all the time as to where this sweater is from. So this is literally just from the men's section of H&M. Check their stuff out. Check out Zara as well too for other different more, I guess, like street style appropriate vibes, because I think think Zara is a little bit more edgy, whereas H&M stays fairly conservative when it comes to their designs. But this is probably one of my favorite ones that I reach for all the damn time, besides my San Francisco one. I think somebody asked me where I got that one from in one of my previous videos, and unfortunately I can't link it because I literally bought it from one of those vendors, like those tourist vendor shacks when we were in San Francisco, so I have no idea how to source that one for you. But honestly, if you guys check out sites like, I think Princess Polly, Misguided, they have a bunch of those kind of branded destination location sweaters that you can purchase. Moving on to matching sweat sets. So I actually don't have that many of them. This is the only one that I have that I think really is like a sweat set. So I'm gonna share it with you. It was a recent acquisition of mine. If you have already seen my set active haul, then you'll definitely have seen these pieces. But it is the matching crew neck oat milk sweater and their oat milk joggers. So love, love, love these ones, and I've been wearing them non-stop since they came in last month. They are so comfortable. If you are on the fence and are unsure if you whether or not you want to take the plunge and purchase your own set active sweat pieces, I highly recommend them. They're not only really comfortable but insanely thick and soft inside. I have taken Kobe out on countless walks with just literally the joggers and the sweater and a jacket on top, and I feel so warm, whereas some other sweatpants that I have, I definitely have to layer on leggings underneath before I put the joggers on top to stay warm. These ones are like thick. I'm not even joking. Like, you can't feel the wind blow through this. I don't know what kind of material they're using, but it's super warm. So this is my favorite one thus far. I picked a neutral color out primarily because, once again, I wanted to be able to wear them separately as individual pieces after wearing it together as a set. Primarily at the moment, I am wearing it as a matching set because that's the look right now and I just really like how it looks. And then I just throw any sweater over top. I would recommend that if this is your first matching sweat set, to maybe get a neutral color so that you can wear any sort of jacket over top. I found that because this one is like a creamy beige color, I can literally wear any jacket and it looks perfectly fine. Whereas if I was to purchase, I don't know, like a forest green one, I have a floor length pink puffer coat that maybe wouldn't look the best with a forest green sweat set. So just highly recommend for your first one to get a neutral color so that it can match with everything. Love, 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 love this one. And I actually really want to get it in their new, I think it's like a cocoa color. They just recently released a brown shade on their site that I'm obsessed with, and I really actually want to get some workout pieces in that color as well. Another sweat set that I like, it's not really a sweat set, I guess you would categorize it as one, but it's made of like this really soft jersey cotton material. I'm just gonna double check what the fabric really is made of before I continue talking because I feel like I sound like an idiot. In here it says 66% rayon from bamboo, 28% cotton, and 6% spandex. So that's probably why it's so stretchy and so soft. So these are the bottoms. They're just like a black pair of joggers. So these are from the Canadian company Pure Balance. I really like these because they're very thin and feel like second skin. Just a simple pair of black joggers. They have an adjustable waist at the top that's super stretchy, and then at the bottom it's just like a nice loose cuff here that's not too stretchy at all. It also comes with a matching sweater. This one actually has a hoodie attached to it, and I actually really like this one because the material in the sweater is a little bit thicker than the pants. I don't know why it differs that much, but it's nice and thick that it has some weight to it without feeling like it's too hot and like suppressive when you're wearing it. So it has a little hoodie up here with a drawstring. Same thing, long sleeves. It's kind of like a batwing sleeve, and it's not cropped, but it's not like oversized either. It's like a nice comfortable length that sits and hangs around your waist. So I actually really like this one on days that it's not too cold because it's not a really thick knit material. You're definitely going to feel the wind when you wear this because it's relatively thin. If you're gonna be wearing this outside, then I would recommend wearing leggings underneath. That's exactly what I do when I walk Kobe. I throw on a pair of leggings and then throw this one over top. But this is a set that I actually wear when I'm just at home and I know I'm not gonna be going out that much and I don't have to worry about being cold. And if I do need to go run an errand, I just throw a jacket over top really quickly and pop into the car. And I actually think this one looks really cute too because it's black, so it's very chic. There is no crazy branding on it. The only thing they have are on the pockets of the joggers. Also forgot to mention they have pockets on either side, which is great. Has this like little X on it here, super subtle. And then on the hood, the only branding that you really see is actually at the bottom hem here. It is so tiny, this little X, and it's really cute. What they've done is because if you flip the tag over, it has a little message here, and this one says be here now. So it's kind of like a reminder to you to just kind of be in the present and to enjoy just what you have at the moment, and I think that's really sweet. Love this set, so stretchy and comfortable. It feels like second skin when I'm wearing it at home, so a huge fan of this one. The last loungewear piece I'm gonna show you guys is actually more what I would consider luxe lounge. This is a matching set from a Banana Republic that I got during the holidays, and it is 100% cashmere, looks like this. These are the pants, and it is in this like really nice kind of, I don't know why, but every time I look at these pants, I think of acorns. It's like the color of an acorn. It's like a nice, soft, warm brown color. High-waisted with a thick band here. It's not adjustable, but it is thick enough that it's gonna hold it up without being too tight, that it feels like it's sucking in your stomach. I'm not the biggest fan of the pockets that it has on either side of the pants here, because I am a heavy side sleeper, and when I sleep on the sides, I can feel these on my legs, and it's not the most comfortable, so I don't wear this set to sleep, although I do wear around the house a lot. And then on the bottom, it has like a nice loose hem here. It does cuff in a little bit, but it's not too much. It's just very, very comfortable. And to go with the pants is a matching hooded sweater. Love, love, love this one. So comfy. Looks like this. It's the exact same color. No drawstring on the hood, just because I guess they didn't want to incorporate that into the design. And they also have the matching pockets on the left sleeve here. So bottom of the cuffs for the wrist, same material and the same style as the bottom of the pants. And also the bottom of the sweater has the same kind of like cuffing, ribbing material as well. So this is my more luxe loungewear set, because it is 100% cashmere. I've been on the hunt for a cashmere set for the longest time, just because I wanted something that was a little bit softer on my skin. You guys may have heard me mention it a couple of times in my H&M and Zara hauls, because those two retailers do release cashmere sets every once in a while, but every time it's released, it instantly sells out like this in my size, and I have yet to been able to snag one for myself. So I am really happy that I actually managed to grab this one from Banana Republic over the holidays, and it is so freaking soft. I wear it all the time. Like I said, this one is more of a luxe loungewear, so I don't wear it all the time. I don't wear it to sleep, primarily because it is cashmere. I don't want it to pill, and also because of the buttons and the pockets on the sides of the pants and the sleeve are a little bit distracting to me when I sleep. So yeah, I don't really go to sleep with these ones, but I actually do wear this one out quite frequently. Whenever I'm spending time with family, or if I was to go visit a friend, I would probably wear this one because it's a little bit more put together. It looks a little bit more clean than some of my other loungewear sets. So yeah, this is my luxe set. I don't know if these two pieces are still available on their site. If they are, I will make a point to link them down below. And if they aren't, I will find some similar ones to link as well. I know these ones came out during their holiday collection, so it's probably either sold out now or just in very limited stock. So just wanted to keep that in mind in case you guys were also looking for a cashmere set as well. So that is the end of the video. I hope you guys enjoyed my favorite loungewear pieces collection. I don't even know what to title this video at this point. I'm gonna have to come up with something before this video goes live. But I guess like my ultimate loungewear pieces and must-haves for the stay-at-home, work-from-home person. I thrive in these, and I kind of essentially rotate through these on and off depending on my mood, whether I just wanna stay at home all day and vegetate, or I wanna get dressed up in loungewear, like luxe loungewear, and go out and do groceries. But yeah, these are all of my most recent, frequently worn loungewear pieces within this past year. I would love to know which ones from these are your favorite, and if you have any specific retailers that you frequently go back to shop from to find your loungewear pieces. I know Aritzia has some phenomenal ones. Everyone keeps ranting and raving about the boyfriend pieces from their sweaters to their sweatpants. So I may have to check this out eventually. I've just been holding off because I have so many sweatpants already that I don't want to add more to my collection. But everyone that I've spoken to that owns a pair thoroughly loves them, so definitely need to check those out. But yeah, let me know where you guys shop for your loungewear, because I would love to add a couple more pieces to my collection. Maybe add a couple more like matching sweat sets, because I only really have one that I truly love right now, and everything else is just like a hodgepodge. But it would be nice to have a couple more so I can swap up my outfits here and there whenever I want to wear another matching sweat set, and I don't necessarily want to reach for a cream one. But if you guys want to see more of me, you can always follow me on Instagram right here, and you can check me out on TikTok here as well. I do a lot more kind of like comedy, funny, humorous videos. Otherwise, make sure you guys are subscribed to my channel to be notified every single time I upload a brand new video. I post videos every Thursday and Sunday at 7 p.m. EST. And if you want to be part of the early fam, you want to have your notifications on, because I will be replying back to comments within the first hour of all my videos going live. But otherwise, I hope you guys are having an amazing day. Stay safe, and I will see you in the next video. Bye. We'll be right back.